America as a nation standing today fends off an invisible enemy. Malaise has soddened our hearts, hearts which have been slashed to bits by defeatism alone, hearts touched by no blade and by no gun bullet. We fall today from poisons from the inside, from mental illness and from addiction, from loathing the self and from seeing our neighbors with wrath. We today succumb most often to deadly sin, with no enemy nations at our national throat. During the Second World War, American science rushed to construct the first atomic weapons. During the Cold War, American science rushed man to the surface of the moon.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Now our science is dedicated toward creating more addictive and more profitable substances, such as drugs, medicines, and synthetic processed foods. Today, more than ever, we face a crisis of confidence. This crisis is eroding not only our government, with massive distrust among voters for both presumptive nominees of the 2024 election, not only our science, with grocery stores flooded with ultra-processed foods and pharmacies charging fortunes for life-saving drugs, but truly, what has been eroded in America is the confidence of the individual. Everything in this nation costs money. You drive everywhere in a car, which costs money to purchase and runs on gasoline, whose price balloons with every day. Driving requires a driver's license, where we are obliged to pay for driver's education and a price to take the learner's permit and driver's license tests. The car is legally required to be insured to be driven on the road, not to mention the roads and freeways littered with tolls and city streets where you must pay for parking. Some industries seem purposely designed to gouge as much money as possible from the American consumer, with it impossible to get anywhere without a car unless you are within a select few big cities. When a person is faced with a problem, medical or spiritual, the only available resolutions today cost money. Want to see a doctor or a therapist, you'll owe hundreds of dollars. Want to hang out with friends, go to the bar and spend money on alcohol. Not to mention, to get to any of these places where you'd want or need to spend your free time, you must forfeit some of the gas in your car's tank, as well as the wear and tear inflicted from driving your car those miles.
The threat is nearly invisible in ordinary ways. It is a crisis of confidence. It is a crisis that strikes at the very heart and soul and spirit of our national will. We can see this crisis in the growing doubt about the meaning of our own lives and in the loss of a unity of purpose for our nation.
In the late 1970s, America faced a similar crisis to what we face today. Gas prices had surged, with huge lines waiting at gas stations for rationed fuel, following war in the Middle East. Democratic President Jimmy Carter was elected in 1976 and served a single term from 1977 to 1981. In July of 79, around a year before the election of 1980, Carter would deliver his famous Crisis of Confidence speech, often dubbed as the Malaise speech.
Human identity is no longer defined by what one does, but by what one owns. But we've discovered that owning things and consuming things does not satisfy our longing for meaning. We've learned that piling up material goods cannot fill the emptiness of lives which have no confidence or purpose.
What is American purpose? To the megacorporation and to our government today, the American purpose is to consume. While sin is what ravages good people, our government and our corporations wish us to engage in gross gluttony, consuming all that we can, for consumption pushes the cogs of capitalist society without reform. We are pushed to spend as much money as possible to go anywhere, to seek care, to have fun, to eat food, to drink water, to meet the basic necessities of human survival. For American purpose revolves around the concept that anything that doesn't involve an exchange in money is not worth existing or happening at all. After all, nothing is free. To survive, you must gain and then expend, earn and then consume. The crisis of confidence we find here is that, as Carter says, the things we own and the things we consume give us no human purpose, no true human identity. We as humans wish for more in life than simple consumption, but despite this, the masses of this great nation have been poisoned with the sin of gluttony, led from the dark cave of self-reliance into the light of consumption, dragged by the collar by our greed-infatuated national leaders, from corporation CEOs to the members of multiple branches of our federal government. A year after he delivered his brilliantly contrived speech, President Carter was crushed electorally by Ronald Reagan in the election of 1980. Carter was stomped out by the American electorate, as is every little flicker or ember of human creativity or small change which threatens to upend the status quo of our national consumption, gluttony, and greed.